On the summer's busiest holiday weekend, beaches like this one ought to be packed, but take a look. There's been nobody around all day except for cleanup crews, hazmat suits instead of bathing suits on a changed Gulf Coast.
Take a picture of that one. Pure gold.
On July 4th weekend, this is what the Gulf should look like.
This is heaven. This is like heaven.
Brenda and Pete Boggs caught redfish and speckled trout on Bay Rambo, one of Louisiana's few fishing areas reopened since the oil crisis began.
We weren't sure if we would be able to fish.
And now that you are?
Well, I really would like to be able to see a lot more people being able to.
Other waters should be just as ideal for fishing on the 4th, but look around. No sign of oil, but not a boat inside either. Oil worries have closed one-third of all federal waters in the Gulf. Off Louisiana, that's everything east of the Mississippi.
Right now, the loop current is closed.
Admiral Paul Zukunft is the Coast Guard's new point man for this disaster. Today, he toured the spill zone where a whale, the world's largest skimmer, was being tested to help the admiral decide whether it should join this response.
So right now, you know, the Coast Guard is really focused on the removal aspect of this operation.
Oil removal in places like Gulf Breeze, Florida. EPA Administrator Lisa Jackson walked along its oil beaches and said she wouldn't go in the water.
They're getting the largest pieces and leaving a lot of smaller pieces that I don't know if you can ever get.
Even rumors of oil chase away tourists. In Destin, Florida, cancellations have cost the Henderson Park Inn $200,000 and General Manager Ryan Olin his peace of mind.
I got a wife, an 18-month-old son, and another kid on the way, and it's a scary feeling.
It's a different 4th in the Gulf when fishing boats want more company.
It can be tons of boats all around.
Just because times have changed.
Times have changed.
Sad.
It is. It's sad. I'm happy today, but I'm sad about the situation in general.
Cleanup crews lost most of the last 3 days due to bad weather and Hurricane Alex. But in Sunday's forecast, sunny skies and a return to Louisiana's broiling summer temperatures. Mark Strassmann, CBS News, Grand Isle, Louisiana.